Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to The Morning Rant. The rant I do while I telecommute from my home to the office, because it's 7 years I do this road, this path, all days, all my working days. And so I try to talk to a camera and to say a lot of meaningful stuff to you so you can learn something new, and I pass my time while I telecommute, okay? In The Morning Rant, I always talk about something related to my work as a TV commercial director, or to my second job as a software developer for TV commercial directors. I develop tools for people who produce video and audio, okay? Today, I want to talk about hallucinations in artificial intelligence and how to avoid it, okay? I want to focus on my product, Transcriber, which uses a Whisper large language model to transcribe audio and to do speech to text, okay? I use this model developed by OpenAI, the people behind ChatGPT, and I want to talk about how I try to reduce the impact of hallucinations in my app, okay? The same model is used in other apps. The most famous one is Mac Whisper, that I salute, okay? Each app uses this big business logic to build around it a product with human interaction and to produce results, okay? Everybody who uses this large language model, all these models, need to be aware of hallucinations and need to try to reduce them as much as possible, okay? But what are hallucinations? Okay, let's go to some other generative artificial intelligence, such as ChatGPT. If you ask something to ChatGPT, ChatGPT will answer you in a more or less complete or correct way. But if you start adding instructions, if you start adding something, let's say, no, you're wrong, doing this, do this in another way, if you continue to increase the context and the instruction you give it, in the end, ChatGPT will start to say something completely crazy. Because ChatGPT is a large language model and it's trying to accommodate your needs. And if your needs are so many, and each need is in contrast with other needs, sometimes you can say it crashes and it starts doing things or saying things that makes absolutely no sense. Let's think about the role of HAL or HAL in 2001 A Space Odyssey, which was explained in the subsequent movie and the book 2010, The Year of Contact, okay? HAL was given so much instructions that were conflicting each one and then kills everybody. Okay, I hope that hallucinations from ChatGPT or other artificial intelligences will not destroy humanity, but let's be aware of it. But hallucinations didn't come only from conflicting prompts, but also the way those machine learning models were trained, okay? Let's say that you have to build something like a large language model, such as ChatGPT. Then you have to have millions and millions and millions of documents or written documents to train it, okay? You can say, okay, let's build an LLM based only on what Shakespeare ever wrote, okay? You take all the stuff that Shakespeare ever wrote, and then you train a model with a very, 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 very tiny number of documents, but you can say, okay, maybe in the end, the output of this large language model will be something that resembles Shakespeare. But the complete opera of Shakespeare is not so big. You need a million times more documents to train a very, very large language model. And so you have to take all the Shakespeare opera, and then Homero, and then everything you can scrape from the internet. And that is the problem. You start scraping from the internet. You take unreliable sources, biased, and with mistakes and errors. Not just typos, but something completely wrong. You can scrape something from Reddit and it's a Nazi page. A page that incites hate and racism and white supremacy and other stuff like this. Or a page that bans and condemn homosexuality. Or other or scrape pages that bans and condemn homosexuality. You have a lot of stuff that you can do scraping from the internet without a human and a clear and sensible supervision. And then you have something that is very, very, very strange. You have millions of documents in several languages, and inside this big trained model, huge, infinite trained model, all this stuff are hidden inside. And so they represent a very small percentage of what's inside a model like this, but it's not zero. And sometimes this stuff can emerge. Now let's talk about Transcriber. Transcriber uses Whisper, which is the technology that OpenAI developed for speech-to-text, and they released it as an open source. You can do whatever you want. Okay, and so a lot of people took these models and did whatever they want. Most of times, developer like me developed a speech-to-text application. There are countless apps like this. But how did they train this model? They say that they used 600,000 hours, more than 600,000 hours of audio content with the associated text, okay? In a lot of languages, something like 40 or 50 languages. 50% of this is English. And so English is very, 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 very cool and pristine and precise. But when they switched to other languages, the people who did the training, those people were not paid so much. They hired a lot of people from third world countries and they paid a little. And those people were not mother tongue. So they took whatever they can take from the internet to do text associated with audio in sync. And they scraped a lot of stuff and they used a lot of subtitles. You know, in the early 2000s, they were not Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, Disney Plus, Apple TV Plus, Paramount Plus, and whatever plus you can think about. And so a lot of people were watching abroad, outside the US, US content with subtitles. And those subtitles were provided by people who were typing them overnight to give people in the other country the subtitles for this series. I learned a lot watching Dr. House with English subtitles. But all the people that were typing these subtitles in real time, at the end of the episodes, added something like a copyright or a disclaimer. Those subtitles were provided by X. And so there were a lot of content all around the internet with these subtitles, with these texts that were not in the original content, but they were added in a dirty way from the people who typed them. And if you give those episode audio to this model to be trained with these wrong subtitles, then you have tons of this kind of stuff hidden inside the subtitles. Let's say that you have a TV episode and in the end the talking stops and then starts a music, boom, or a special effects. And when this boom or special effects on the, or with this music, there is a disclaimer. These subtitles were done by X. And then the model is trained, so every time it hears something like a boom, it translates it, it transforms it into the subtitles were done by X. And there are a lot of stuff hidden inside this model. This model is free. We have to accept it for what it is, but it's full of this garbage. And so people like me who produce this kind of apps needed to focus only on the dialogues and to strip out all the stuff that this it's not dialogue. And so my apps does two kind of pre-pass for audio. First pass, with another machine learning model provided by Apple, tries to identify the areas or the time frames, the time ranges where there are people speaking and not when there is music or sound effects or something like this. This is almost precise. It's not perfect, but it's quite precise. And then I try to do a second pass to do a clustering filter, something like a noise gate, but using clusters. It's quite complicated. I will talk about it in a next episode of this The Morning Rant. And I'm producing a tutorial to instruct the people how to use the clusters for their transcriptions. The Whisper model is like a big black box, and you have to provide it to an audio, and the result is a synchronized text. And so my strategy for leaving out these audio hallucinations is this one: try to filter the audio before giving it to Whisper. So I have to filter all this stuff, try to identify where there are people talking and not where there is music or sound effects, filter it with another label, clustering. And then if you have an hour episode or something, you can have multiple, like dozens or sub audios with very little time slices that were given to Whisper. This is my strategy. It's not perfect, but those models are not perfect. You can think about artificial intelligence, something like it's precise 95 to 97% of times with English languages. With other languages, this percentage is decreasing. With Italian, it's something like 90, 92. And then you have to filter all this stuff to reach the maximum level you can reach. You cannot do 100% sure stuff. Yeah, yes, we will do this in the near future when new models will be released and new services will be released. You will have to pay this kind of stuff. And you have to certify the training. You cannot hire 1,000 people from North Africa to provide hundreds of thousands of hours of content without supervision. Because if you train a machine learning model with garbage, you have a garbage machine learning model, and then it's not useful. Yes, it can be useful, but it's not perfect. And you always have to supervise the job after it produces the results. I will say that my tools are not meant to be a complete substitution of the human being. I use these tools, I provide these tools, I develop these tools to help my job and to transform my job in something like, okay, maybe this kind of stuff can be done by an intern or a less trained person or a newbie. And then, because I am a director, I can direct it. I take all the results from these tools and then revise them, control the results, and then I sign them because it's my face, it's me. I cannot rely completely on the work on machine learning model. I have to control all the stuff that it does. But control is less time consuming than production. And this is my goal. Okay, that's all for this time. Please let me know what you think about it in the comments and if you have more questions, okay? I will be very glad to answer everything. And if you want me to talk about a specific argument, please let me know. I'm here and I want to practice my English while telecommuting. And for now, that's all. I invite you to visit my site, alti.media, to discover all the apps that I produce. And that's all. And as we say in Italy, ciaone, and it means a very big ciao, or bella zio, that means your uncle is beautiful.